question I often get asked about is about how do you fit different people in a boat? If you've got tall people and short people and putting them in the same boat. Now, let's be quite clear. The fact that you're tall with long levers does give you some advantage in rowing a boat, but in most cases, particularly in the junior ranks and in school, it doesn't mean as much as you might think. What's most important is being able to row a boat well, row it with good rhythm, not upset the boat, and you find you get good speed out of that. If you think about why this is so in a single, why there's not much difference. If you have a 60 kilo person rowing a boat and the boat weighs 14 kilos, then the difference is so great between the weight of the boat and the weight of the person that the influence of the body weight is more important than size, essentially, than height. If they use their body in an incorrect way, then they're going to find they get a poorer outcome. And indeed, a big person in a boat has more capacity to slow a boat down in a crew boat than a small person does. If you picture a very big heavyweight crew, if they come into the front inappropriately, they're going to have a much bigger checking effect on that boat than a lightweight crew, for example. So size, weight, they're not that super important for beginners. One of the problems, though, is how do you fit them in a boat together? And particularly with school children, is you'll find that often you'll get some that are really quite tall in the same year group and some that are quite small. And that may, in fact, only be a transient thing that give them 2 or 3 years and they've caught up to each other or changed. So it's, you often find you get large height differences in athletes in a boat. So the critical step really is to make sure that all of them are comfortable in the boat. So if you've got a tall athlete in the boat, they're likely to need to have a greater feet to seat height. And indeed, if they're less flexible, they're likely to have a greater seat to feet height. Whereas a smaller athlete, a shorter athlete, may find that it should be that it's a lot less distance in the feet to seat. So what I suggest you do is make sure they're all comfortable, they can all get to the catch position at the same time, with the correct posture, with their shins vertical, and they fit well on the boat and it's comfortable for them to row. Because if it's not comfortable for them to row, then you're going to get poor outcomes in any case. Second thing to do is if you've got large differences in height, then what I suggest you do if you've got a number of crews using a number of boats, I'd suggest set one seat in the boat, or two depending on how many athletes you've got of different sizes, so that it'll cater for the larger or the smaller athlete. The things you're likely to have to change is seat to feet height, often shoe size, and quite often the gait height, because a tall person's going to have the gait higher in order to have the handle of the oar at their sternum level and the blade in the water at the correct depth. So I'd adjust those and I'd choose a seat, maybe the 2-seat, 3-seat, and I'd set that so that it suits a taller person. So when you're swapping crews around, you can say, well, the tall person always goes in seat number 3, because then it's a lot easier rather than having to re-rig boats, or worse, have the athletes have an uncomfortable row because they don't fit the boat. So I'd suggest get that fixed first. Then, if you're in a boat where you're likely to have the same people in the boat all the time, or indeed in that previous example where you've always got a tall person in the 3-seat, then you can change the rig so that it fits. One of the problems with tall people versus short people in a boat is that the angles in the water are quite different. And you'll find that with a shorter person, the arc is going to be less than someone who's tall, the arc is going to be longer. And you want to try and match them up a little bit. The simplest way to do it is to just move the gates. So you move the gates out if you've got a tall person and move them in if you've got a shorter person. So you may find in a sculling environment, for example, you may have one athlete rowing with a span of 162 and you might have another athlete rowing on 158. The shorter athlete 158, taller athlete 162, you'll find their arcs are the same. A really good way to match a crew up so that you get everyone with a similar arc and similar power profile. The problem though, and you need to be very mindful of this, is that by changing that, you're changing the gearing quite significantly. So you need to change the oars as well. And so I suggest get our gearing app, New Boat Which Oars, and available on the App Store for Apple, and use that, or use the formula itself, just to calculate what the oar should be. So if you're going to move the pins out and get a wider span, then you're going to need to have a longer oar. A longer oar by itself, if you don't get the inboard-outboard adjustment correct, is going to generally mean a heavier workload, and you probably don't want to do that. You want to have the workload to be very similar through the boat in most cases. And so you need to adjust the oar in order to get the same workload. So they'll have a longer oar and they'll have more inboard, but the gearing will be about the same. Same with the shorter person. If you're going to move the pins in a little bit, say to 158 in a sculling environment, then you might want to change the you'll need to change the oar length, so they end up with a shorter oar, but they've got a shorter inboard as well, so the gearing should be okay. In a sweep boat, it's exactly the same, just it's only one oar, of course, and you might find that you have some of the athletes rowing on 83 from centre line to the pin, and you might have some athlete that are rowing on 87. Again, matches the angles up, and it's important. The problem, of course, if you're in a club school environment where everyone's using the same boats, is it's difficult to make those adjustments without upsetting the other crews, and to make those sort of adjustments where you adjust both the span and the oars every time you row is going to be frustrating for everybody. So I'd suggest don't do it for that environment, just put up with the differences. But if you do have the opportunity and you've got a relatively consistent that there's one tall person every time in a boat, then I'd suggest rig a seat so that it's set for a tall person, which may even include different oars for them and a wider span. And if you've got a crew that you have a number of shorter people in it, then you may do the same opposite, have a narrower span and a shorter oar to suit. So I think it's worth thinking about that in order for everyone to have a comfortable row and to get the best outcomes. So to fit taller people and shorter people in a boat, that's the way to do it from a technical rigging perspective. There are other things you can do, and I'd be careful with some of these though. If you've got a short person, if they tend to lean back further, then that's going to give them some extra length, and that's useful. And indeed, I'd suggest that you do that. Whereas a tall person, because they've already got their blade a long way around towards the stern of the boat, they don't really need to lean back much further. So unless you've changed the arc a lot, then I'd suggest have the shorter person tend to lean back more, and I'd have the taller person sit a little bit more vertical, because you're going to get a good outcome that way. Second thing to be very mindful of, if you have an athlete that's got really long arms, a tall athlete with long arms, then make sure that they don't sacrifice their length in order to try and fit in. It's much better to rig it out than to get them to sacrifice their length, because if they're sacrificing their length, then you're actually wasting part of the power of the stroke. So you want to make sure that they don't sacrifice their length and shorten up. In fact, what it tends to do if you leave them rowing long is it'll tend to make the shorter people have to try to row a little bit longer. So I'd suggest short people, have them lean back a little further, and have the taller people sit a bit taller, and make sure that the longer people, the taller, longer arm people, that they use their full length all the time when they're rowing, and put them in positions in the boat, or seating in the boat, so that they're tending to lead. And so then what that'll mean is that unless they're not good at that role, of course, but then you'll find that the shorter people will tend to make sure they get their full length, which won't match, of course, but they'll try to get their full length. And then if you rig out the difference that's a result of that, you'll find you're likely to get a faster boat. So shorter people and taller people, don't think it necessarily makes a boat fast, but if you put them together carefully, like we've just discussed, then you're likely to get a more harmonious boat. It'll feel better and it'll go better.